I'm on the phone with Ruby Corado. She's a Latino activist in Washington, D.C., a transgender activist. And she has some good news for the Latino community in Washington, D.C. Ruby, tell me about this center that you are planning on opening on June the 6th.
This is a long life dream that I had since moving to D.C. in 1992. I found myself, opening my apartment to many of my friends, and I realized they were crashing at home. And, after a while, I was like, there's always something at my place, and I really love that. And I found out some of them didn't have a place to go. So, therefore, they will stay at the house, and we had a great time. And through the years, there were some people who had a home and they had a place, but they always wanted to be, in my place. So through the years, I realized that I started helping people in areas that they really needed. Some of them didn't speak English. Some of them, needed to go to the doctor and have someone translate for them. So I began getting involved in activism because I spoke English and then it didn't. Mm-hmm. So with the years, I felt like we needed to have our own place. And, I did some community work and I helped to organize other groups in other organizations, but I always felt we needed to have our own. So this is really the first time that D.C., Maryland, and Virginia will have a place for Latinos where it is run by Latinos. Decision makers are Latino LGBT. So it's our place. We're not housed in somebody else's organization. We have our own.
Which is very important. Yes, I can definitely relate to what you're saying. When I moved to the U.S. 15 years ago, I was always looking for a place for Latino LGBT community, and I could not find any. How long have you been doing activism within the Latino LGBT community?
I consider myself starting in 1992, when I actually, was trying to get spaces in other LGBT organizations for Latinos to come and access services. So from there, I reached out to friends and people and I wanted to open those spaces. And I got really big in my activism in 1995 because, there were a few LGBT people in the city and sort of, I started getting together, and then when we had the first gay club in D.C., which was called El Faro, and I learned more about it, and then all of the community started growing. In 1999, I really, really, really got very vocal about the needs, and I created, some spaces with my walker and other organizations, so I've had the space since 92.
Great. Now, this new center will be called the Casa Ruby. It's named after you.
Yes. Casa Ruby is basically the product of 20 years of my work. And the vision that I have that Latinos who are LGBT, can have their own space. Their own decisions are made by gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender Latinos. We don't have anybody else making those decisions for us.
Okay, and what specific projects will be done by Casa Ruby? What's the main goal of this project?
The main goal is to service people in the areas of employment and economic development. Mm-hmm. We also have a project for immigration and legal services. Mm-hmm. And there's an area of health promotion and prevention, and the one that is really important is the social services, where people will come in and we will do intakes, and if they need emergency services, we will put them in touch with an array of services that I have great relationships with, where they always help my people. So we also be doing things to make sure that people have access to resources.
And you work with other organizations in Washington, D.C., right?
Yes, I have a lot of partnerships. One of the main partnerships is with the district government, where, you know, for the first time in years, we have had the mayor be a great supporter of LGBT issues. And certainly, he has, you know, been a great supporter of my issues.
And what about other LGBT groups?
Well, you know, I'm also a transgender woman, so I had the opportunity to grow up in this city being a gay person. And, you know, when I was pretty much growing up, you know, I got to know lots of places like Smile, like the DC Center. I got to know places like GHE. We also had HIS. With my walker, and some other places, and
like the DC Center and HRC, perhaps. Are these groups supporting these projects?
Yeah, let me tell you this. Most of my work has been done on local issues. However, because we're in the nation's capital, I have worked with other national organizations. I was one of the first Latinas who put together the first leadership conference for Latino transgenders in 2003 with National Digo, which is the National Gay and Lesbian organization that was in D.C. for many, many years. I was the first board member of Unidos, which right now is the National Gay and Lesbian organization for Latino. I worked with HRC, and early on during the years, I worked with National Gay and Lesbian Task Force, where I have many friends. I work with National Center for Transgender Equality. I do outstanding work with immigration equality, which I love. And I know a lot of other organizations that sometimes reach out to me because people know, like if you Google my name, you will see kind of some of the areas that I worked on.
My question is, all these organizations that you work with in the past will support you in this new project?
They are thrilled. it's amazing. Everybody's like really excited because even though I have, you know, worked with Latino LGBT, people know that Ruby is from D.C. So I can go into any neighborhood. It doesn't matter if it's African-American, if it's, you know, Caucasian. They know who I am. And I help anybody. I just happen to be Latina, and I have worked with, you know, Latino LGBT. But in this city, pretty much everybody knows who Ruby Corado is.
That's great. That's great. Yeah, I heard of your name, okay, as well, and the work that you have done. I wish you the best. Tell me about the opening ceremony. When is going to be held and what time?
It's June the 6th. It is going to be in the form of an open house that will start at 12 o'clock. It will end sometime around 7 p.m., and we do expect to cut the ribbon sometime between like 3 and 4. We are expecting Mayor Vince Gray and many other officials and other people from the community who have worked with me for many, many, many years to be there and celebrate, you know, and this is probably going to happen between 3 and 4.
So everybody says welcome to attend.
Anybody. But I do want Latinos. I want Latino LGBT because the reason why I decided to name it Casa Ruby is because, you know, I am Latina. I know the challenges. I came to this country when there were no resources for Latinos, period, nonetheless for LGBT. So I want people who listen to this, that if you know someone who does not speak the language, bring them over. If you sympathize with Latino culture, we want you to come to Casa Ruby because we want people to, you know, embrace each other. So, and you don't have to be LGBT. You're welcome to come.
That sounds great. Well, thank you so much, Ruby, for this interview, and I will see you on the open house day on June the 6th. And if anybody wants to contact you, say, to support you in any form of donation, or anybody who want to work with you, how can they reach you?
They can go to our web page, which is Casa Ruby. It's Casa, C-A-S-A, Ruby, R-U-B-Y, .org. They can look us on Facebook at Casa Ruby. They can tweet us. And there's a target list that we have for, like, office supplies, chairs, things that we will use in the community center. So it's going to... You know, or they can call this number, 202-355-5155. I always tell people, if you want to help and you don't have money, come. We will find something for all of us to work. You know, up to this point, you know, I haven't had any money, but it didn't stop me from doing anything work because I know the need. So I want people to recognize that they can do the same too.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Ruby, and I'll see you on June the 6th.
Okay, baby. Take care.
Okay, ciao.